Is Apeel Safe? This is a new substance put on fruits and vegetables. I'm Dr. Eric Westman, and welcome back to my channel where I review and debunk nutritional misinformation online. In this video, we're going to look at a review of Apeel by a chiropractor, and then be sure to wait till the end of the video where I give you my final comments. So Dr. Livengood is a chiropractor, and you always want to consider the source of the videos. Thanks for sending and giving ideas for videos. But it doesn't, I suppose, matter who the source is unless there's a lot of opinion or things that are not scientific. So if we review an article, it's the article we're reviewing, not the person reviewing it, although the reviewer of the article might have certain opinions about it. So that's why I want you to consider the source of the information that you're getting. Even in the keto low-carb world, if you're learning tips and pointers, but the person is using the approach for something other than you're using it for, then you want to be careful in assessing that information. So Dr. Livengood is a chiropractor. It's hard for me to tell if he's in clinical practice. Again, I think that's important if you're going to get someone's opinion or judgment on how to gauge changes for someone, for how to individualize things. But this is a more general video about the harms or benefits of a new product called Apeel. Let's see what he has to say.
Good week to you. It's going to be a good one. Declare it right now. That'll be a great week. Getting lots done and you're making progress. You might screw up, but it doesn't matter. We're focused on progress, not perfection. Right here for you guys right now. I want to talk about the Apeel controversy. Not like a congressional appeal or some political appeal or a court appeal. A food protector backed by some skeptical, questionable figures. It's going down right now. The Apeel food covering backed by Bill Gates, creating a big stir on social media. What's it all about? What do the facts say? Is it safe to eat? How do you identify it? Do you have any options of washing this new chemical that they're putting on our foods off? I'm gonna break it all down for you right here, right now. What's up, everybody? It's Dr. Livengood. Just recently, I've been getting a lot of buzz, a lot of questions. People will come to me as your trusted source, a trusted source, and just, hey, can you give us some simple truth? Can you dig into this? Can you give some research on trends or things that pop up? And I like to slice through that kind of stuff and often don't get overly excited about too many things or try to bring you a perspective of clarity when things get too far right or too far left. But the new one right now is Apeel, A-P-E-E-L.
Now, you know, this seems like a great start. And I didn't really understand the anti-Bill Gates thing. Unless, if you're, you know, thinking that anything he's involved in is bad or, you know, that's not a scientific opinion. Although it might be true that, you know, let's try to stick to the science about it. And just because something is going to be making money, for example, it doesn't mean that it's anti-scientific or harmful. But aside from that ad hominem, meaning it's against the person, not scientifically, it didn't really have anything to do with the product itself. Let's carry on.
Apeel. And it is a food coating, right, that is going on foods to help them not oxidize and break down too fast. So behind me, like I have a couple of bananas and you're seeing the oxidation process just begin. That's the brown part where it begins to break down. And it goes from more of a green probiotic food to more nutrient dense to, changing to decomposing and going back into the earth. And there's, 40 to 50% of produce that ends up getting wasted in the world because it doesn't get eaten in time. We overproduce oftentimes. So we'll use things like this plastic in order to try to seal a thing like a cucumber to last longer. But then we end up putting a lot of plastic into the world. So a company that's been around since 2012 created a chemical that they put on foods that is not a wax that you might find like on an apple to try to prevent that, but can go on all kinds of foods like an avocado or an orange or all kinds of things. And it's creating quite an uproar.
Well, first of all, my first comment is I don't eat much of those things. I don't know if this really is going to apply to me. I don't see that they're putting Apeel on steaks, for example, or chicken or So keep that in mind as we go through this. It might be more of an issue if you eat lots of fruits and vegetables, which I don't. And if you want to keep the carbs really low, you don't want to eat lots of fruits and vegetables. And if you keep fruits and vegetables in the same sentence, you really don't understand that fruits and vegetables have different metabolic effects. Fruits have a much higher glycemic index in general compared to vegetables, unless the vegetables are really starchy, like potatoes, sweet potatoes, things like that. But so these are chemical or a chemical that's put on something that rots or oxidizes. And the idea is to keep it fresh because there's so much wastage in terms of this fresh fruit and vegetables that people, well, I've had that happen in my own refrigerator. So one thought that comes to mind, though, is if you eat locally, you know, or you create your own vegetables, and this won't be such a big issue. So it's really targeting the mass produced food that gets sent around. And you know, I don't know the last time I had a banana, now that I look at that.
Anytime Bill Gates gets involved nowadays, very controversial, debatable, problematic sometimes figure. And so people have really strong opinions against that. But him, Oprah, Katy Perry have all invested in a large company called Apeel. And so I did some research and did some digging on this. Is this something we should be concerned about? Is there some facts to what's going on here? And, you know, kind of what is it? So here we go. I'm going to dive into this thing and wanted to, out of the gates, show you this. So let's go to this split screen here. So this is the Apeel's website, right? And it says, you know, how do we know it's safe to eat? What is it? It's a plant-based derived mono and diglyceride lipid, which are found in seeds, peels, and pulps of plants that we already eat. These ingredients are also found in human breast milk. They're formed in the human body during the natural digestive of fats and oils. Apeel uses these plant lipids because they have a long history of safe consumption, 50 years. Okay, so they're, you know, assuring us there's not trans fat in there. It's non-GMO that these are coming from. The big concern that a lot of people are having, you know, is there heavy metals in there, is we're ingesting mono and diglyceride. What are those? Why is that a concern? And is this actually a harmful thing for you to be put into your body? Well, a lot of the controversy came from, I'm going to answer that question in just a moment, came from this little sheet right here, right? Let me show you this one. This is a data safety sheet for Apeel right at the top. See this? But it's under the professional hygiene identifier. So I got this sent to me and I was like, oh, okay, but why does it say personal hygiene? And it said neural hard surfactant cleaner. And then I kept going. And I'm like, all right, I'm going to decipher some of these. I'm used to looking at stuff like this to vet, you know, maybe a supplement or an ingredient. And, it, you know, it had all these dangers of causing eye damage. And you need to wear protective clothing. And if you ingested it, it creates problems and you needed medical attention. And I started getting concerned. And then I saw it contains alcohol and, you know, terpenes. And I'm like, wait a minute. I don't know if this is actually what they're referring to. Turns out this is actually a spray. It's a cleaner named Apeel. And it just happened to have the same name. So if you see this report, okay, shut that one down because that one's actually not true, right? So we don't want to be spreading misinformation when we're talking about these things.
Well, that's an important reason to do at least some sort of research, and my ability to find actual studies about Apeel being given to people, it was pretty limited, and that doesn't seem to be much. It's generally regarded as safe by the government, so you don't have to show really any safety profile. But so is sugar. Sugar is generally regarded as safe, or GRAS it's called. So because these have been around, it's assumed that they're safe. The other issue that comes up, though, is if the fruit or vegetable inside is going to change and oxidize or rot, it won't look like it is. So you might not be able to tell how ripe the fruit is. But the whole idea is trying to keep the wastage down on these fruits and vegetables. And using, you know, a substance that's been around, I think a lot of people would say that it's fine. Another site that I looked at basically claimed that it's the chemophobes who are worried about it, meaning the people who are irrationally, neurotically afraid of chemicals, who are afraid of it. But at the same time, we really should know what it does in our body before it's generally put out there, I would think. And some level of investigation should be done before you give it to people. Imagine if the sugar industry had to show that their sugar in massive consumption didn't cause obesity and diabetes. Well, they didn't have to show it, of course, and it is probably the root cause of the current diabetes and obesity epidemic, but it was generally regarded as safe, and no one could ever believe it would be consumed in this amount. You know, Halloween candy, mounds of it like this. So I guess if you're going to be just eating fruit and vegetables, you might get a big dose of this. So you want to know what it's doing. But again, I'm not sure I'll be eating much of this because I don't eat a lot of fruit and vegetables.
And we want to be accurate, right? So that was actually a surfactant cleaner, which of course would be dangerous if you inhaled it or ate it. And it does have alcohol in it. This spray-on, dippable, or rub-on Apeel oxidative cover doesn't have that type of warning. However, it is created out of those mono and diglycerides. This right here is what we want to pay attention to. So what are those? All right, it's a simple Google search, right? I'll save you the time. Natural sources of fatty acids. So they're correct. They said these are found in breast milk. And then, all right, they naturally do occur, and they're a part of plant oils. So this got my attention. Whenever you start messing with plant oils, if you know Dr. Living Good, these can be very dangerous little buggers, or they can be beneficial depending what type of plant they come from. So what types do they come from? Well, I Googled exactly that. Soybean. Okay, that's a problem. Unless they're using non-GMO soybeans, the Apeel is probably not from that. We don't know what it's from. It doesn't say. That's part of the problem. Bill Gates is behind it, and we don't know exactly what's in it. They're being tight-lipped about that. So then it's like, you know, there are some things in the world that it's a little bit harder, like perfume, exactly what, you know, the 72 things it's made out of or how they make it. Like, I get that. But with this, when it's going and being dipped on our food, you know, you kind of want to dig a little deeper, but it says non-GMO. So I'm going to assume it's not soybean, but could be grapeseed. I don't have a problem with grapeseed, right? Canola, I have a major problem with. That's made from a rape seed, not a grapeseed. And it is linoleic acid. It is a PUFA. It's a polyunsaturated fatty acid. That's a big problem in your body. Sunflower, if it was high oleic, yes. Or organic, yes. But I don't know, and I doubt they're using the higher end high oleic to create this stuff. Maybe. Cottonseed, I would have a big problem with that. Coconut and palm, I wouldn't have as much a problem with, okay? And then they're found in animal fats, which is what puts it in breast milk. But to put that on your disclaimer on the website, it has nothing to do with that. They are naturally occurring, right? But if they're from a toxic oil, which is occurring in so many different crackers, breads, grains, flours, all kinds of baked goods. And I have a huge problem with them because what we find is they live in your body for over 300 days when they get in there. And they make up your actual cells, which congest your cells. So nutrients then, because of these bad fats that are deformed, not like a saturated fat that's nice and fluffy and easy to enter, these bad fats clog it up. You can't get nutrients into the cells.
Well, you know, I don't eat a lot of those ultra-processed foods. I hope you don't either. So you're not going to be getting much of that other oils. And you know, I have to say, I'm not the science is not really strongly saying that these kinds of oils are all that bad, and not compared to the science that says excess carbohydrates are bad. And on a program like I teach, you're not going to get much of that stuff anyway. So, but minimizing those sorts of oils is fine. I think it's a relative minor thing.
You can't get toxins out. You become inflamed, and you actually speed up oxidation in your body. So it's just very interesting. Plus, the problem with this is that whatever protective layer they're putting over it, they actually show on their website where there is a regular decomposing avocado and then one that's covered with a peel, and it lasts 20 to 30 days longer. Well, if God wanted these to last 20 to 30 days longer, he would allow them to. So now I'm a bit skeptical of it. We just don't know exactly what it's made of. So I don't need to be given the wrong information about the surface cleaner, but this stuff's being put on our foods now, and it's even being put on organic foods. That's the crazy part about it.
Well, that, you know, God would have let the avocado live longer. Well, you know, if humans were meant to fly, we would have wings, right? I mean, so I don't think that that's great scientific logic, because, or maybe, you know, airplanes are not supposedly, well, you know, so science. Or the face validity of it's unnatural to have an avocado be available to eat for that long doesn't really muster much science, in my opinion.
And so you start, you know, asking around and asking your supermarket, and you, some of the symbols are actually, it says Apeel right on it, right on the food. And other times they're not marketing it very well, but it's starting to roll out, because what farmer and what grocery store, if there was and presented in a decent way that they could save their produce another 20 to 30 days, that they would not want to do that? Like, it makes sense. I understand the global movement behind it. I understand, you know, reducing waste, but they're defending it saying chemicals, we're all made of chemicals. Everything that you know is made of stardust, whatever that means. That's, you can look that up. That's literally from the co-founder of the company. My problem with this is like, yes, we're all made of chemicals, like water. Would you consider that a chemical though? I mean, so there's chemicals going on here. If they are canola, cottonseed, soybean, even potentially sunflower, depending on what version it is, we've got major problems and we don't know. So then when I don't know like that, then I would pick non-Apeel. And anytime we can keep the food closer to the way God made it, the better it's going to be for us. But this is a very large controversy that is going on right now, and I wanted to make you aware of it so that you could have the details. Here is the PDF sheet that says mono and diglyceride of fatty acids. It does not say where, but it does say derived from edible plant oils. There are very few plant oils that are not very congestive and very oxidative in the body. And so this could be a definite concern for you if you already suffer from high triglycerides, high cholesterol, heart problems, valve problems, vessel problems. This would be something definitely to watch out for. Now, okay, Dr. Livingood, I'll just scrub it off. I'll just wash it off. Well, actually, it's interesting that you asked that. Right on their website, this question has been posed enough times that they actually put it on there. So let's go over to it. So how much of the mono and the diglycerides would I be ingesting? That's how much per fruit or avocado or whatever you're eating, okay? Can I wash it off? You could remove some of the Apeel plant-based protection with water and scrubbing, but it's unlikely that you'll be able to remove all of it without damaging the produce. Apeel forms a semi-permeable barrier of edible plant material on the skin or the peel, and it wouldn't maintain the fruit or vegetable's natural freshness if it was easily removed. For that reason, we only use food ingredients to make Apeel, so it's safe to eat along with produce. We're extremely proud of our products. I'm sure you are. You've got some very, very, very deep-pocketed backers that are putting money towards this. And, you know, it's a good intention, good cause, I believe. However, are we now covering fruits and vegetables with rancid oils?
Well, I'm not sure this is fear-mongering about this substance or whether it's a legitimate concern. But then, you know, how would you study something like this? If you had a product like this and gave it to people or mice, or but let's do people, and then you follow them over time and measure some sort of outcome, what would you monitor? And how long would it take for some bad effect to show? So it's going to be tough to show that it's harmful unless people start reporting rashes and things like that. So it is, I can see why it's just kind of let out there into the market and generally regarded as safe. But I also think it's fair to be concerned about things that aren't studied. And even though these mono and diglycerides are healthy and, well, in healthy foods, there's a lot that we consume that if it's you're a susceptible person or if it's a large dose of something, might not be so healthy. So I don't know. I'm not compelled to eat more fruits and vegetables as a result of this, not being able to change whether Apeel is being put on it. But you might eat locally. You might grow your own if you're really concerned about having that put on, or just don't eat much of it. I hope that's helpful. And if you like, be sure to like, subscribe, ring the notification bell. We're dropping new videos on Wednesdays and Fridays. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and check out AdapterLifeAcademy.com.